Everybody, I've got a fan here to look at. I have owned this fan forever, probably dating back to the very late 70s, maybe, the like 1978 or 79. I bought it when I was in probably junior high at a yard sale, and it was like probably 10 bucks or less, probably less than 10 bucks because I didn't have any money when I was a junior high. But there is absolutely no markings on it at all as to what brand it is. But from what I have done is, or what I've done is, I've gone on YouTube and looked for fans that have that same, like fan shroud around it. And everything I find that has that comes back being a Superior Electric Company fan, and I'm assuming that it may have had a, you can see there's little tab holes in there, like right here, and like right there, where there was probably a center spinner label with their logo on it at one time that has gone missing. Like I said, I've owned this fan for, now we're looking at, so if we're talking early 70s, we're in the early 2020s, so, or not early 70s, the late 70s, so like 89, 99, 09, 19, we're looking at 40-something years that I have owned this fan, and I've not really ever done anything to it. I think for the first time, I just grabbed my little spray bottle and did a quick wipe down of it. It was kind of pretty grungy because it's been sitting down here in the DJ booth collecting dust, and I haven't used it in a couple of years. It's usually at the lake is where it usually lives, and I had it in my bedroom at the lake, but that was before I had the air conditioner in the bedroom at the lake, so I don't really need it there now. So I brought it home. I figured I had never done anything to it other than use it, and it was getting kind of rattly sounding and stuff and whatever, and I figured it probably could use some oil, so I did oil it recently and give it, like I said, I gave it a bath with some paper towels and spray cleaner. Just, I didn't take it all apart and go crazy with it. I just took it apart. I mean, it's got a whole bunch of chip paint and whatever. This thing on the front there, when I was a kid, you can actually see the edge of it right there, that blue thing, that is one of those Dymo embossed label makers tapes, and my name is on there. When I was a kid, I put my name on it, and I don't want to take it off because that's part of my history with it, so I just covered it up so you can't see what my real name is. But it's an oscillating fan. It has a different sort of oscillating mechanism. You've got to loosen this thumb wheel up and then move the whole thing. You want to basically, this little U-shaped bracket right here has a long slide thing on the bottom of it. So you go from being all the way up to the center where it's pointing straight ahead to the full out position, and then retighten it. And then, oops, looks like I'm retightening it the wrong direction. And then it should oscillate when you turn it on. And it's a single speed fan. All it has on the side is this little thumb wheel switch to turn it on. I think when I got it, the bolt that went through here was broken or stripped out or something, and I found another bolt that just kind of sort of fit in there. It's like way too big, but I fixed that probably back in when I was like 12 or 13, and it's held up ever since, so I'm not gonna deal with trying to find a better screw because that one's been holding up now for 40 something years. And so now let's just we'll turn it on and we'll see how it works. It works pretty good. Okay. as you can see, it oscillates nicely. And you can grab the whole thing and you can tip it and change it, you know, directions a little bit. It tips up and down. It does rattle, but I think it's rattling a little because the counter that it's sitting on isn't quite level. And shut it off. And as you can see, it's got decent spin down. A spin down is usually a little bit longer, if I don't have it oscillating in it, so it doesn't use up any of its energy trying to push the whole fan back and forth. Which way am I going? Going the wrong way. All right, let's start it up once again. The oscillation should now be off. And here it rattles a little, not too bad. You may need to have that bolt tightened a little. Seems like it's the head unit out here that is rattling. So if I grab it, it stops. Shut it off. And it's got decent spin down. And that probably is the result of me just oiling it. It didn't spin down. It didn't take that long to spin down before I oiled it. So it probably desperately needed some. Because I, like I said, I hadn't oiled it in 40 years. And I doubt that it had ever been oiled before I bought it. I'm assuming that this fan is most likely from maybe the late 50s. I'm guessing somewhere in there. I have no real idea. I've seen some newer fans from this company that I think it's from, the Superior Electric, and they look, the base looks a little more modern and stuff, so I'm thinking this is older, so I'm thinking this is probably mid to late 50s, but it just, it runs, and it's good. Actually, let me go, and I'll grab my thingy, we'll see how much power it uses. Hang on just a second. All right, kilowatt is what I was trying to think of. And we got it set for watts. Let's turn it back on again, and we'll see how much juice it uses. So it uses 58-ish watts, 58.5 or so, roughly. Not too bad. And it does move a decent amount of air. I mean, it's not super, you know, wind tunnel kind of machine, but it does move a decent amount of air. I think the blade is just a little bit out of balance. I think that's also, yeah, because it you can kind of see it when it was slowing down that it's a little, yeah, you can see it there. It's kind of not, kind of goes back and forth. It's not really balanced very well. But hey, you know, it's considering, so if this was mid-50s vintage, then we're talking that this is getting to be over 60 years old, maybe coming up on 70. So, hey, I'm sure I'll be a little wobbly too when I get up to being 70. So I don't think I'll worry about that too much. Like I say, it doesn't get used too much. It's probably, it may end up going back to the lake because we do have a tendency to need it up there more than I do here because here we have central air and I don't really need fans. But so anyways, that is my quote, superior electric, as far as I can tell, oscillating fan from what I've been able to figure out looking up fans on eBay, and that I've had for over 40 years probably. And we thank you for watching, and take care. We'll see you in the next video. Bye now.